Hello and welcome to Easy Learning, Smart Learning. Today we are going to start Java programming in English medium. So let me introduce the syllabus for this playlist. The syllabus I have downloaded from Pandit Ravi Shankar Shukla University, which is located in Raipur, Chhattisgarh. And this course belongs to the students of BCA, and this syllabus is also similar to MSc IT third semester, as well as some of the universities around the world. In this lecture, I will also tell you how you can kickstart Java programming from zero if you are a beginner. If you don't know anything about programming language, that is not a big problem until or unless you have to decide that you have to complete this programming language within at least 2 months. Every programming language or any programming language needs time to practice. And one more thing I want to add, that syllabus is the key to complete any course. So first of all, you please compare this screenshot with your syllabus. I am also going to put this syllabus on the playlist. You can check the description of the playlist to copy and paste the syllabus, and along with that you can just compare your syllabus with this one. So first I am going to complete this syllabus, or in between, if someone comments on the section of my YouTube video lecture, I will consider that and I will make a separate video along with the playlist within this session. So please be with me and help me to put some comments on the YouTube section, so that it will be really helpful and fruitful for you. So let's start with first topic of the syllabus, which is Genesis of Java. The term Genesis of Java, you can consider that where it is originated or where it comes from it. You can also consider it as history of Java, or you can say introduction to programming Java. So I have mentioned here 2-3 slides. You can just read it out, or I will read it for you to understand better. I have copied this text from Geek for Geeks website, so you just listen to this once. Java is an object-oriented programming language developed by James Gosling in the early 1990s. In some context, it also, you know, mentioned that Java introduced in 1991, so that is a part of history. So exact history, you know, it is sometimes slightly different from website to website and books to books. So just you can write 1990s and developed by James Gosling. So the team initiated this project to develop a language for digital devices such as set-top boxes, television, etc. Here we can see two different platforms. Number one is set-top boxes, number two is television, and here also mentioned it is etc. So why this is written here? Now you can start considering that set-top boxes and televisions are two different entities, two different devices. Even Java programming can run in any electronic device. You just have to mention a code for that, because it is also mentioned here digital devices. So it is a platform independent language, which we will consider later on. But from the beginning, you have to understand that Java is an object oriented programming language, and it is also platform independent. Platform independency means it can be run on any platform. That platform should be a digital device. Originally, C++ was considered to be used in the project, but the idea was rejected for several reasons. So before it was discussed with C++ that we will start with, let's say start with C++, the same project. But they rejected this programming language for some reason. What were these reasons? For instance, C++ required more memory. That more memory consumption is the drawback of C++ programming language. So if you don't know C++ language, please don't blame that it consumes more memory, because C++ is also a powerful object-oriented programming language, but it consumes more memory. So that is why they rejected that. This is the main reason behind that. Now, Gosling endeavored to alter and expand C++, however, before long surrendered that for making another stage called Green. James Gosling and his team called their project Green Talk, and its file extension was .gt and later became to known as OAK, or you can say Oak. Now, why Oak? The name Oak was used by Gosling after Oak Tree. It is an, you know, tree. So that remained outside his office. Also, Oak is an image of solidarity and picked as a national tree of numerous nations like the USA, France, Germany, Romania, etc. But they had to later rename it as Java, as it was already a trademark by Oak Technologies. So now the Java name comes from, you know, this different names. So you can see what were these names: Green Talk, Oak, before its extension what .gt, and then finally it comes to Java. So now Java. Gosling and its team did a brainstorm session, and after the session they came up with several names such as Java, DNA, Silk, Ruby, etc. Java name was decided after much discussion, since it was so unique. The name Java originates from a sort of espresso bean. You know what is that? It is a coffee. Java. Gosling came up with this name while having a coffee near his office. Now, Java was created on the principles like robust, portable, platform independent. Now, here comes the name I was explaining you, that it is a platform independent, high performance, multi-threaded, etc. So this was called one of the best products of 1995 by Time magazine. So it is also published in the Time magazine that this is the best products of 1995. So currently Java is used in internet programming, mobile devices, games, electronic business solutions, etc. Java language has experienced a few changes since Java Development Kit 1.0. So this is the first version of JDK, Java Development Kit, where you actually built your programs, just as various augmentations of classes and packages to the standard library. In addition to the language changes, considerably more sensational changes have been made to the Java class library throughout the years, which was developed from a couple of hundred classes in JDK 1.0 to more than 3000 in J2SE5. So this is J2SE, means Java 2 second edition version 5. So that's for all today, and in the next lecture we'll discuss the next topic of the syllabus. The next topic of the syllabus is important to the internet, so we'll discuss that. And I have assumed that you have made a notes for Genesis of Java, and you will prepare a question from that. You know, sometimes they publish a question like write short notes on Genesis of Java or history of Java. You can write all those four topics in detail, and please learn some more things about Java introduction so that it will be easy for you. So in the next session we are going to learn importance of Java, importance to the internet of Java, and thereafter we'll go topic by topic. So please let me know how was this lecture in the comment section, and if you like it, please press the like button and share with your friends and colleagues who wants to learn Java programming language with me. Thank you very much. See you on the next lecture.